हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल नॉलेज ट्रेंड। इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी स्टडीड अबाउट द फिटल्स कॉर्ड। सो नाउ यू कैन सी देयर इज अ पेल्विक बोन। वी विल स्टडी टुडे अबाउट द पेल्विक बोन द ऑब्स्टेट्रिक एंड गायनेकोलॉजी। सो वी गिव द मेन इंपोर्टेंस इन द ऑब्स्टेट्रिकल डायमीटर ऑफ द पेल्विक ब्रीम एंड हु इज द पार्ट्स ऑफ द पेल्विक बोन एंड हु इज पार्ट विच बोन्स एंड व्हाट नंबर ऑफ द बोन्स आर कनेक्टेड टू फॉर्म द पेल्विक बोन। So we will start now. At first, the pelvic bone is connected to form whole by three bones. Okay, first is the innominate bone. There is two innominate bone. This whole is known as innominate bone. Okay, there is two innominate bone. One sacrum and one coccyx. You can see one sacrum and one coccyx. One pelvic bone is formed by three type of bone. One is innominate bone, another innominate bone. There is two innominate bones, one sacrum and one coccyx. Okay, so after that we have to know about the parts of the pelvic bone in lines. Okay, but first we have to know what is this. This is the pubic bone. You can see this is the acetabulum. Okay, this is the fossa. This is the fossa is known as acetabulum. Here, when the head of the femur is connected with this is known as hip joint. Okay, you can see there is a line. Okay, from below this is pube. This is ischium. Okay, below this area this is ischium. Okay, upward up to this area this is ilium. And up to this area, this is pubic bone. Like that, here is divided like this. This is the ischium. This is the pubic bone. And up to this is the ilium. Okay? After that, this is the sacrum and coccyx. Then we have to know what is this. This is you can see there is a joint. We say that it is the pubic bone. Means this is the joint of the two pubic bone. This is known as what? Symphysis pubis. Okay, that's symphysis pubis. As this is a pubic bone, this is a crest like area. Okay, so it is known as pubic crest. Okay, this is pubic crest, and here is this part is known as pubic tubercle. And you can see as this is whole is the pubic bone, this area whole is known as pubic body of the pubic bone. Okay, then this area is known as anterior ramus of the pubic bone. Okay, and this area up to this area is known as posterior ramus of the pubic bone. Okay, then we have to move forward. You can see there is a line comes from the inward to outward. Okay, there is an inward to outward. This line is known as pectineal line. Okay, and here is a line. Okay, here is a line connected to the ilium. Okay, so it is known as iliopectineal line. Iliopectineal line. And here there is an iliopubic prominence. Okay, this is iliopubic prominence or iliopubic eminence. Okay, then we have to know that there is a sacrum. We know that this is sacrum and this is ilium. So the joint between the sacrum and the ilium is known as sacroiliac articulation or sacroiliac joint. Okay, then this area, okay, these two area is known as the ulna of the sacrum. You know this is the sacrum, this is the sacrum. So these two area is the ulna of the sacrum. Then you can see this is known as the base of the vertebra. Okay, because when this pelvic bone is cut here, this is the base of the vertebra. Okay, at this area you can see this area is known as promontory, sacral promontory. Okay, this is, you know, this is the sacrum, so this area is known as sacral promontory. Okay, we discussed about the parts. We just forget the ischium part. We discussed about the pubic, ilium, sacrum, all. This is the coccyx, you know, this is the coccyx. Okay, and now the ischium part. the ischium here, you know, this is the ramus of the ischium, right? Ischial ramus. Okay, this is the ischial ramus, and here you can see a spine. This is one is ischial spine. Okay, this is the ischial spine, and you can see there is some holes. These are some holes. Okay, these are known as the foramen of vertebra. Vertebral foramen. Okay, these are the vertebral foramen. And you can see here is also a foramen. This is known as foramen of the obturator. Okay, this is the foramen of the obturator. Okay, we know about all the parts of the pelvic bone. Now we will discuss about the joints. What are the joints? There is 1, 2, 3, and 4 joints. In a pelvic bone, there is only 4 joints. Okay, these are the sacroiliac joint, 2 sacroiliac joint. There is a joint between the sacrum and coccyx. Okay, that's known as sacrococcygeal joint. Okay, that sacrococcygeal joint, and the joint between the pubic bone is known as symphysis pubis. Okay, you know about the joints now. Now we have to know about the false pelvis and true pelvis. Pelvis is divided into 2 parts. One is false pelvis, another one is true pelvis. Okay, now you can see the part only visible, the upper part. Okay, the upper part, that this area is known as what? False pelvis. Okay, this part is known as only false pelvis. When if we stand like this and you say see only this part, this is the false pelvis. Okay, so this area is the false pelvis. Okay, when our uterus, this area, you think that if this is the false pelvis, what is the work of this false pelvis? When our uterus is here, and here the ilium, the false pelvis, is support to our uterus to hold in the in our abdomen. Okay, after that you have to know that this area is known as breed. Okay, breed, this area is known as breed, and this is the true pelvis. Okay, this is the true pelvis. When the which area of the pelvis is obstetrically worked, that is known as true pelvis. Okay, when the baby is comes out, you know, the mother is already, when in the normal delivery case, the mother is like this position. Okay, the baby is goes like this, and this area where the engagement takes place. Okay, this is area where the engagement takes place. This is known as inlet. When the baby goes inside the cavity, that is known as inlet. When the baby in the there is internal rotation takes place in a whole area, that is known as cavity. Okay, that is cavity. And when the baby at last comes to outward with external rotation to outer, that is the outlet. You understand that? You can understand now that is this upper area of the hole is the inlet. This area is the cavity, and the outer area where the baby comes out, that is the outlet. Okay, so don't be confused between the inlet, outlet, and cavity. Okay, this area is the inlet. This area under inside area is the cavity, and the outside area is outlet. Okay, understand? After that, we have to know about the diameter of the obstetrical area of the pelvis. Okay. There is the different diameters. Okay, there is we measure the inlet diameter. Okay, we measure the cavity diameter. Okay, there is the anterior posterior diameter. There is in the anterior posterior diameter there is 3 type of diameter. I will describe it. Okay, after that there is the oblique diameter and the transverse diameter. Okay, then you have to know what is the anterior posterior. This is the posterior anterior. Anterior posterior diameter. Here there is the, you know, this is the what? This is what? Promontory. This is the sacral promontory, and this is the symphysis pubis. Okay, the anterior posterior diameter is divided into 3 parts. Okay, that is the trio conjugate, ऑफ स्टेप्टिक कंजुगेट एंड डायगोनल कंजुगेट. ओके, डायमीटर इज डिवाइडेड इनटू थ्री पार्ट्स. व्हाट इज द ट्रू कंजुगेट ऑफ स्टेप्टिक कंजुगेट एंड डायगोनल कंजुगेट. ट्रू कंजुगेट इज द फ्रॉम द सैक्रल प्रोमोंटरी, द मिडिल ऑफ द सैक्रल प्रोमोंटरी अप टू द आउटर बॉर्डर ऑफ द आउटर अपर बॉर्डर ऑफ द सिम्पाइसिस प्यूबिस. डोंट बी कंफ्यूज, आउटर अपर बॉर्डर ऑफ द सिम्पाइसिस प्यूबिस एंड दिस इज 11 cm. ओके, दिस इज 11 cm. यू कैन सी दिस इज 11 cm. ओके, देन द अनदर वन इज द एनाटोमिकल कंजुगेट. एनाटोमिकल कंजुगेट, ओके, दैट इज अदरवाइज नोन एज कंजुगेट वेरा. ओके, दिस इज फ्रॉम द प्रोमोंटरी अप टू द इनर बॉर्डर ऑफ द सिम्फाइसिस प्यूबिस. ओके, यू कैन सी एंड दिस इज द 10 cm. ओके, दिस इज 10 cm. यू कैन सी दिस इज 10 cm. ओके, एंड द अनदर वन इज द डायगोनल कंजुगेट व्हिच इज मेजर फ्रॉम द सैक्रल प्रोमोंटरी, मिडिल पॉइंट ऑफ द सैक्रल प्रोमोंटरी अप टू द डाउनवर्ड बॉर्डर ऑफ द लोएस्ट बॉर्डर ऑफ द सिम्फाइसिस प्यूबिस. ओके, एंड दैट इज 12 cm. यू कैन सी दैट इज 12 cm. ओके, सो इन आवर नॉर्मल एरिया देयर वी कैन मेजर ओनली द डायगोनल कंजुगेट. ओके, यू कैन मेजर ऑन डायगोनल कंजुगेट. फ्रॉम दैट वी हैव टू डिडक्ट सम cm, सम सेंटीमीटर्स टू गेट द ट्रू कंजुगेट एंड द एनाटोमिकल कंजुगेट और द ऑब्स्टेप्टिक कंजुगेट. ओके, so we have, how we have to measure. Okay, you know the when we have to measure like this. Okay, the mother is in the sphinx position. Okay, in the lithotomy position with thigh flexed. Okay, here we have to enter with the aseptic technique two fingers. Okay, you can see the this area is the vaginal area, this is the vaginal area. You have to enter like this. Okay, you have to enter like this and touch the sacral symmetry of the middle sacral symmetry. Okay, here and after in the aseptic technique, in the next hand you have to calculate like this and you have to measure this cm. okay, this centimeter you have to measure. This is the diagonal conjugate. Okay, this is the diagonal conjugate. We can measure only the diagonal conjugate. Very rarely we can measure the diagonal conjugate, but we have to find out the obstetric conjugate and the true conjugate from the diagonal conjugate. Okay, to find out the obstetric conjugate we have to make deep. Okay, from the diagonal conjugate we have to deduct 1.2 cm to get the true conjugate. Okay, to get the true conjugate we have to deduct 1.2 cm from the diagonal conjugate, and to find out the obstetric conjugate we have to deduct 1.5 to 2 cm to get the obstetric conjugate. Okay, after that we have to know the diameter of the transverse diameter of the pelvic bone, the inlet, the bleed. Okay, the transverse diameter is measured with the iliopubic pectineal line to iliopubic pectineal line, and this transverse diameter is about 13 cm. This transverse diameter is about 13 cm, but in some cases this is 11 or 12 cm. okay, this is varies in the pelvic bones, in the obstetric pelvic bone this is varies. Okay, but in normally in anatomically it is 13 cm. okay, next we have to discuss about the oblique diameter. This is the oblique diameter. Okay, you see that this is the left sacroiliac joint and this is the right sacroiliac joint. Okay, this is the oblique. From the sacroiliac joint we have to measure the opposite point to find out the oblique diameter. Okay, then we have to know what is the diameter of the cavity. In normally remember the diameter of cavity, the diameter of the cavity is considered as 12 cm. okay, So overall we covered all the parts and topics of the pelvis. After that you have to know that there is four types of obstetric pelvis. Okay, that is the gynecoid pelvis and anthropoid pelvis, android pelvis and platyploid pelvis. Okay, in the gynecoid pelvis there is the rounded shape. You can see this is the rounded shaped beam. Okay, this is the gynecoid pelvis. Okay, in some cases what happens, that is the gynecoid pelvis is found in 50% cases of the women, and in some cases about 25% of the cases we found the anthropoid pelvis. Here what happened, that is the anterior posteriorly, that is oval. Okay, here this beam is anterior posteriorly oval, means this diameter is greater than this diameter. Okay, the anthropoid pelvis is anterior posteriorly oval. Right, then next type is the android pelvis. Okay, here what happens, there is a heart shaped beam. Okay, or heart shaped inlet, where it is otherwise known as the triangular sac. Okay, the triangular shape, it is found about 20% of the cases, and the rare case is the platyploid, where what happens, that is the transversally oval, means this diameter is greater than this diameter. Okay, the transverse diameter is greater than anterior posterior diameter in the platyploid pelvis. Okay, just remember, gynecoid pelvis, anthropoid pelvis, android pelvis and platyploid. Gynecoid is about 50% and it is the round, and anthropoid is about 25% of the cases and it is anterior posteriorly oval. And the android pelvis, here it is takes place about in the 20% of the cases, and it is triangular or heart shaped inlet or brim. And then at last the rare case is the platyploid, here the shape is transversally oval. Okay, so overall we cover all. So now thanks all of you. If my video is very useful to you, and if you get any benefit, and if you want, it's your wish. Just like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you all of you. Thank you.